generations. And now, the power of two restores the one.
We got a bidet. Hey everybody, and welcome to my channel, Dyad in the Rough. Today, I'm talking about some very, very divisive news on the internet, and that is that the Acolyte will not be getting a season two. So what I'm going to talk about is what I thought went well, what I thought did not go well, and what might be kind of a bright spot at the end of the tunnel for this show. Because I do not believe that they're going to completely abandon this stuff. So let's start talking about some of this stuff. So I want to talk about what did this show do well, in my opinion. There were some of the characters that I really liked. There's three of them that really come to mind. One of them is Jackie. I really liked Jackie. Chimer, I thought he was pretty cool. I really liked Chimer when he had the helmet on, per se, and he was our Sith baddie of the show. I also liked Sol most of the time. There was a couple of times where Sol was kind of iffy, where, you know, I questioned some of his thought processes, but it is what it is. For the majority of the time, I really liked Sol, Chimer, and Jackie. So what else was really good about this show? Well, it was our first glimpse into this new era of Star Wars, the High Republic. And this is basically Disney's playground of what they want to do with Star Wars. Of course, they do have some things to think about beforehand, because Knights of the Old Republic is before this. And then, you know, our Skywalker saga is after this. And, you know, from where this show was coming from, it was supposed to be like 100-ish, depending on how you interpret how they wrote the blurb in the beginning of the show, 100-ish years before our Skywalker saga. So there's not a lot of time in between there. So they kind of have to be somewhat faithful to what's about to happen, but at the same time, you know, be their own thing. So that was supposed to be an exciting aspect of the show. I also think there was a lot of cool ideas. Unfortunately, I don't think a lot of those ideas necessarily made sense or paid off. So, for example, the bleeding of the crystal. When I saw it for the first time during the show, I thought it was really cool. When you know, try to match that even with what Disney has established as Star Wars lore, it didn't quite make sense as to how that worked. Same thing with some of the lightsaber battles. They looked really cool. They were flashy. There were some moments where there were some shock factors. So like when Jackie died, I was kind of like, whoa, okay. We went there. Like my first thought was, okay, she's not really dead, but it's pretty clear that she was dead after what happened. So there was that. But even aside from that battle, the one in the middle of the show, because, I mean, there's a whole video out on what technically is wrong about that whole thing. Let's just put that aside, because, I mean, it was cool. It was flashy. I liked it. Let's talk about the one where Sol and Chimer are fighting towards the end of the show. Some of these, a spitting image of this doesn't make sense was when Chimer was trying to pull Sol's lightsaber towards his helmet because he wanted to deactivate it. All he had to do was put his lightsaber forward. Sol was even trying to pull away from the helmet. You know, like when you're like holding on to your brother or sister's hand and they're trying to get away from you, and then you let go and they smack themselves in the head. They could have done the same thing with Soul's lightsaber, essentially. Just by either letting go of Soul's lightsaber, and he would have, you know, potentially had some enough whiplash to kill himself, or Chimera could have just slashed him right in the head. So there's some things going on there where it's like, it's cool, but it doesn't make a lot of sense. And I feel like a lot of the Star Wars stuff before this show, more specifically, a lot of lightsaber stuff before Disney took over Star Wars, a lot of that stuff had meaning and made sense. So I feel like they could have cleaned up some of that stuff. Was it cool? Sure, but it didn't make a whole lot of sense. Another thing I thought was cool, but just didn't quite pay off, was the witches and magic. Before the show even came out, there was some rumor that there was going to be some emphasis on witches and magic in Star Wars, and I thought that was a cool aspect. Maybe there was going to be some sort of struggle or conflict within the confines of what is defined as magic and what is defined as force, and is there going to be some sort of like clash between the two? Also, the witches. We've had witches in the past. We know they're cool, but this, the way that it was presented and the way it panned out, because the writing was lacking, it left a sour taste in a lot of people's mouths how that was handled. So I feel like that didn't quite pay off. Also, I thought I could have been misunderstanding. I thought this show was supposed to kind of be a whodunit type situation where there's people going or someone going around murdering Jedi, and then, you know, we'd kind of figure things out along the way. We knew right away who was killing all the Jedi. It was just a matter of when they eventually came together. So I really didn't like that aspect. I wish we would have been guessing at least for a couple episodes. Another, aside from all that stuff, another cool thing I thought was great with the show was that they were willing to kill off main characters. This was something that Star Wars was missing during the Disney era, in my opinion. I feel like like when I was talking about how Jackie was killed in the lightsaber battle, my mind immediately went to, she's not really dead, there's something else going on here. That wasn't the case. You know, this show actually had the courage to do that, and that was one of the coolest parts, in my opinion, about the show, was they established, or I should say reestablished, this idea that not everybody is safe, which is a great, great thing to have, because, you know, that causes engagement within the show. If you know that anybody can die at any moment, that it creates more buy-in when there's more tension. That before this show came out, Disney had really started to set the precedent that just because someone looks like they died doesn't mean that they are going to die. And so that tension was gone from a lot of those moments. And as soon as we saw on this show that people were going to die, it really ramped up the potential engagement for the show. Let's see. So those were a lot of the things that I thought went well for the show. What did not go well for the show? First and foremost, the broken promise. So when this was first ever talked about, it was supposed to be a Sith-centered show. It wasn't. For the most part, it was, there's something going on in the background with the bad guys, and we're focusing on a lot of the Jedi stuff. And it was the Jedi that had the main problem in this show. It was the Jedi that, you know, caused this issue with the witches. And the whole show is about a revenge plot from the bad guys, and also the Jedi trying to cover up their tracks on what happened. And the majority of the show is the Jedi trying to, you know, cover their tracks, tell the audience what happened by telling these grown-up children about what really happened. And so that really seemed like a catfish situation or a bait and switch in a way, where we thought we were going to walk in here about talking about Sith, which I would probably say about 25% of the show, which is a significant amount, about 25% of it was talking about the Sith. And the other big thing about that is, with thinking about this being a Sith-centered show, we really didn't learn anything about the Sith, right? We got Chimer. We learned about Cortosis in Star Wars lore. I hope I got that word right. We learned about the metal that deactivates lightsabers. We saw potentially Plagueis. But other than that, there really wasn't anything that was expanded on for the Sith. And that drives me nuts because, again, with this kind of being a Sith-driven show, there should have been something we were learning here, and we really didn't. Before the show even premiered, and we started learning about it at one of the Star Wars celebrations previously, one of the things that really made me uneasy about the show was the actors. And it's not who they picked, it's what they said. So the actors were saying, like, we don't know what Star Wars is. And in their interviews, they're clearly showing they didn't know what Star Wars was. And so that's really, really hard to pull in a Star Wars crowd and have faith in these people when they just flat out tell everybody, hey, we don't know what we're doing. We're just here to act. So it's kind of like improvising Star Wars in a way. I wish they knew their stuff a little bit more. I will hardly ever get over the Anakin destroyed the Death Star. And that was in multiple interviews. That right there is like the poster child of you don't know what you're doing. And so that wasn't great. And then just to add on to the actor part of it, Leslie didn't help either. There was a lot of interviews with Leslie, trashing George Lucas and just going on with a lot of big things, like talking about misogyny in Star Wars and talking about a lot of things that could divide Star Wars. And there's no talk about how we can come together. I feel like the only attempt that they had at let's all enjoy Star Wars together was having a very diverse cast, which was what they intended, which is great. I loved it. I didn't have any problem with it. But I feel like that's the only thing that they tried to unite Star Wars fans with was we can see almost every one of us can see ourselves in some sort of character in this show. Great. But everything outside the show was divide, 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 which was not great. And on top of that, Kathleen Kennedy. So whenever something bad was being talked about with this show, Kathleen Kennedy would just put blame on the fans. The fans are the problem. They're the ones doing all this. No, if you have a Star Wars product come out that is great, has great writing, has great acting, has cohesive story elements, people will love it. They will absolutely love it. Disney literally had George Lucas hand over to them what was next in the project, and they tore it up. And so the fact that they're trying to blame everything on the fans, saying that they are what's wrong with Star Wars, that is not the case. Not at all. That also kind of piggybacks with just some of the, I'm trying to think of what I'm trying to say here. Some of the decisions, like even with the budgeting, so that's another thing that's kind of like outside of what's going on in the show. So $180 million, where in the world did it go? Did it all go to Plagueis and animating that one character that was in the witch coven that needed some CGI? Because there was not a lot of stuff here that looked like it should have cost $180 million. I thoroughly believe that this show should have some sort of audit. Why? Because these episodes were like 30 minute tops episodes on average. And then there wasn't a whole lot of stuff that really needed CGI. If you think about it, there was what, 8 episodes, half hour piece, somewhere around 4 hours of footage. You know, that's kind of what happens with a big budget film, like with Revenge of the Sith and stuff like that. There's usually around 4 hours of film, and then they, you know, cut it down so that it would fit within a theatrical runtime of somewhere between 2 to 3 hours for a project like this, which is kind of what would happen on average. But this show capped right out at that time. That money should have been there. They should have invested it properly. It was not used properly. What's the big comparison? House of the Dragon. House of the Dragon had a similar budget, had way more runtime than the Acolyte, had great leads, had great storytelling. Was it perfect? No, by no means. The first half was great. Second half was kind of meh. But overall, it was a pretty good season. Can I say that about the Acolyte? No. And I guess to kind of give it a better explanation of where I'm coming from with the run times. So I feel like if we had more time with these characters and we had more character development and not just we need to hit these main points for this part of the show to make sense. There's really not a lot of time to breathe in this show. This show was a go, go, go type show. And I think that's because of the runtime. The way that I can best compare this is if you look at any of the Star Wars movies and you look at their novelizations compared to their junior novelizations, I think that's what's going on here. I feel like the show itself was like a junior novelization of what we could have had in The Acolyte. Whereas like House of the Dragon was kind of like the adult novelization of what we would have gotten. So I feel like that's a big discrepancy, right? If you were an adult and you picked up the junior novelization, I pretty much guarantee you would not enjoy it as much as the full-on novelization version of it. The junior novels are watered down and get straight to the point, just like this show. So I think it could have been done way better justice if the time and effort would have went into adding more to those characters. I also really didn't like within the writing that there was a lot of time that was wasted. So it's a short amount of time, right? And the flashbacks drive me nuts. So we had a flashback episode in episode 3, which would be fine if you had a flashback episode there to establish some of what we should know. That's great. Throwing another one that's almost pretty identical right before the season finale was a huge misstep. Absolutely huge misstep. There was nothing, absolutely nothing that set up the season finale. It was almost like it was something on its own. So that did not sit well with me. Not only that, but the show spun its wheels quite a bit as well, especially with the whole back and forth on not really having a clear identity with what the show wants to do. Like the whole May and Osha stuff was so back and forth, it was hard to determine what their motive was. I had no idea why they would be making the decisions they were doing. For May, so I completely understand why May would want revenge on the Jedi. As a kid, she saw this major event happen when the Jedi showed up, and from a kid's understanding and a little bit of push from like a dark side user of saying, hey, they are the problem. You need to take care of them when you get older. I can see why she would want to go out and, you know, kill the people that, you know, essentially killed all of her family. That makes sense. But then going from that, and then like, oh, my sister happens to still be alive, so I'm gonna be a good person today. And then as soon as stuff hits the fan with Chimere, I'm gonna be a bad person today. And then at the end of the show, we're back to being, oh, good person again. When she goes back with the Jedi. So I really didn't like the back and forth so much. I think the twin aspect could have been done very, very well. But it didn't. It did not land for me. Not one bit. But speaking of twin, I feel like this show also leaned a lot into what was already established with Star Wars and trying to say, in a way, it did it first. So we had twins before, we got twins again. Here's how we can be better than what was before. The Virgins. This was a big eye roll for me when we were watching the show. Like, Anakin was special. He was a virgin in the Force. Maybe I just don't know Star Wars lore from the past, but it doesn't seem like the Jedi are constantly looking for a virgin in the Force. Not from my understanding, at least. And so it seemed really weird to just insert that right then, and then that's the whole reason why that Sol wanted to take the twins, was because he thought that they were a virgin, which is, again, what made Anakin special. So I feel like they were trying to say it was done before, we can do it better. Our characters are better than what happened before. And no, not even close. Not even close. And you may be wondering, like, oh, that is so far-fetched. There's no way they were doing that. They were, you know, seeing what's in the Star Wars lore and doing their own thing with it. They were not trying to compete. I call baloney on that, because there is something in this show that they specifically were comparing to episode one and saying, we're going to be better than that. And that was the lightsaber battles. There was a lot of talk of, oh, we're going to be better than the Duel of the Fates. No, you weren't. No, you weren't. Duel of the Fates at least makes sense. So, yes, they were trying to compete with things that George Lucas established in Star Wars and trying to copy the homework and make it look different. So I completely am against the idea of, you know, taking what was there before and trying to say it's your own and you did it. No. And because you're chronologically in before that, in order that you were the one, you know, like, this is your established thing. No, not going to happen. Some of the choices seemed a little forced. So like Sol in the bridge, that didn't make any sense. Why didn't he just grab the girls? They're much lighter than the bridge, and he could have pulled them both towards him. Unless he was deliberately trying to have one of them die. That doesn't make any sense. The witch is all dying at once. So supposedly when they took over, his name escapes me, the Wookiee. When they took over the Wookiee and kicking him out of, or kicking the witches out of his mind, killed them all. That doesn't make any sense to me. Torben committing suicide for what happened to the witches, that doesn't make sense to me either. That was essentially self-defense. They went in there with good intentions, and the witches started it. The witches started the conflict. I know the Jedi essentially broke in. I get it. That's not good. But what happened within the story doesn't make sense. So the lead witch, forget her name, she turns into this thing that looks like that she is going to be a threat. She tries to start, you know, making the essence of one of the children start to fade away. that is threatening to a Jedi. Don't do that. Like, there are, you don't just do things that look like they could cause conflict. And then once you have consequences, like when Soul stabbed her, she's like, oh, we're going to let her go anyways. No, that's terrible writing. Another thing that I really didn't like was when Osha and Chimera were on the island and she was starting to really, in my opinion, surrender herself to the dark side. And she had that lightsaber and she put it up against his chest. It was not threatening by any means because she put the hilt up to his chest. She did not put the blade anywhere near him. And I think that is stupid. I think, pretty sure when we talked about this episode, it was kind of like, you know, if a robber or whoever, instead of pointing a gun at somebody, they just put the side of it up to their chest, that's not going to be nearly as threatening as it being pointed at them. So it's the same thing here with a lightsaber. You don't just put the hilt up against somebody. You put the blade right underneath their throat. That's how you tell them you mean business. Otherwise, you just look silly. So I thoroughly believe that there's a reason why this show is not getting a season two. It's not just that people hate it. It's not that just people are racist and sexist. Those are all cover-ups for the people that are just upset that it's not being renewed. I'm sorry to say. Sorry, not sorry, so to speak. It's the substance. Did Leslie take a chance? Yes. Disney should have done a better job of looking at it and trying to make things make more sense. This was a very fast-paced show that did not care about character development. It cared about hitting these story points. We got about 30 minutes to do, you know, 8 episodes. We're going to waste time with one of them towards the end, right before the finale, just so we can kill all the hype right before the season finale, and then hope that people absolutely love this last episode, which still didn't really make any sense with how the thing with the twins was handled. So it was a little bit of a mess. And maybe Disney looked at that $180 million and was not happy about its return. The viewership was not there. Even though people are trying to say it wasn't. You have to look at the actual numbers. And overall, I don't think the audience really cared for it. I do think that it tried to bring in some new points of view into Star Wars, and that's great. But at what cost did some of those choices, you know, I mean, I'm not saying that it was bad for them to make decisions to bring more viewers in. What I'm saying is they should have done it in a way where it brings people in and it's a nice cohesive story. Because they definitely did not bring in more people and pay respect to the Star Wars stuff that's happened before. It was kind of like a almost ignoring slash, like I said, trying to copy the homework of somebody else. However, if you are one of those people where you are very, very upset that this show is canceled and you think that it's just never going to be revisited, I think you really need to think again. There's no way that Disney is going to leave this and just let it die, okay? First and foremost, they have books coming out already about these characters. They've already announced it. It's not necessarily after the show, but there are books coming about these characters so that you can, you know, live with them again. So Disney loves selling products. So the books they've already announced, that's going to happen. They're not just going to let this show go to waste. One of two things can really happen, in my opinion. One of them is, I mean, if this show is called The Acolyte, they may have what might be quote unquote season two called like Plagueis the Wise or something, where it's its own show and maybe they'll actually focus on the Sith this time, but these characters could still be a part of it per se, right? Because, like, this show is called The Acolyte, but the actual content of The Acolyte was very minimal, right? And then we had a whole bunch of Jedi stuff going on. So they could essentially do the same thing. Call it Plagueis the Wise. It'll be its own little section of the show. And then there'll be other things going. I could definitely see that happening. Right now, I think there's a chance they could be testing what is the audience reaction. Will there be some sort of talk amongst fans to, you know, want the season two, and kind of just seeing what people will do to react to it? But I fully believe that it's not over. I believe there will be another show that has these characters in it. It may not be called The Acolyte Season 2, or there'll be some sort of literature. They love selling books. They love selling comic books. There's a lot of Star Wars Disney lore out there within the book space. So I could definitely see this coming back in some sort of capacity within those realms. Video games, too. That's a great place to explore some of this stuff. I know there's supposed to be a High Republic game coming out called Eclipse at some point, as long as it doesn't get canceled, of course. So I think that'll probably be our next big chunk of High Republic type stuff, as long as it comes out. But like I said, those of you that are really, really behind The Acolyte, don't be too worried yet. I think they're just trying to figure out what they want to do in this space, maybe reevaluate, maybe do some writing that, you know, would make a better connection to where this show is supposed to be heading, with the Skywalker saga and stuff ahead and Darth Plagueis. What would do your homework, essentially? Like they should be writing a show that pays respect to, you know, what fans know to be the lore. Because the quickest way to upset the fandom is to say, we are Disney. We are going to do what we want for Darth Plagueis, and everything else that you know is trash. And then when they release their product and it's nowhere near as good as what was before, that's the quickest way to lose your fans. So I think they really need to do their homework here and make proper connections. Because the way that this show was going, I think they were probably going to try to do their own thing. I'm pretty sure Chimera was not a thing back when Plagueis was being talked about before. So they were trying to insert their own thing in there with Chimera, and I don't think it was going to pay off. I think that they were going to really drive this into the ground if they kept with this creative freedom, quote unquote. I think they need to double back, make sure all their I's are dotted, T's are crossed with the lore, and then try something. Really give the fans something that has hard work put into it that connects the entire audience. Definitely have that diverse group of actors and actresses. That was great. But also make it make sense, make it relatable, make it likable. Okay. I think we're probably pretty casual Star Wars fans over here on our channel, and it didn't quite hit for us. So I don't think it takes much to please it. I guess love is a little bit of a stretch. I really like the Kenobi show. It has its faults. It has its problems. But honestly, that's probably one of my favorite shows because it has some really cool character stuff going on with Kenobi and Vader. Book of Boba Fett wasn't the greatest show, but I would like to see a season two just to see where can they go from here now, just, you know, to make things better. So there's a lot of stuff going on here. I'm rambling at this point. We're going to wrap it up where I don't think just because they say it's quote unquote canceled, that they're not going to do something else with it, that there aren't people that like it. Of course, there's people that love this show. There's people that want more from it. And as long as Disney knows that you want more from it, there will be some capacity where you will get more because they want your money. So that's the end of my little discussion, my thoughts here on the whole Acolyte being canceled. basically just talking about what went well, what did not go well, in my opinion, and potential for this not being the end of the road for these characters in this time frame. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. Drop a like if you liked the video. And if you have a very strong opinion about the Acolyte, whether it's agreeing or disagreeing with me, go ahead and put it in the comments. And then, as always, everybody, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.